Hello students, this is Vansh Naik from Canara Engineering College. Welcome to my Vastek channel. So we will continue the session of MP, microprocessor and microcontroller, module 3 of 17 CS44 syllabus for 4th sem CSC and IIC students of VTU. So in this session, we have already completed memory interfacing, string operation, and signed number operations. So in case of memory now, the pending concept is data integrity in RAM and ROM. So data integrity ensures a very important role because it will check whether the stored informations are correct or not. So what are the methods we use to check the integrity when the data are stored in RAM and ROM? The methods are used are checksum method, second one is parity bit method, third one is CRC, cyclic redundancy check. So cyclic redundancy check and checksum methods are also used in network transmission to check the integrity of the transmitted message. So first you will see checksum method. So checksum byte, ROM may be corrupted due to surge current or due to spike or some other problem during the operation. So we will use checksum to detect any corruption in the content of the RAM. So what is this checksum method? This checksum method may uses a checksum byte, an extra byte that is tagged to the end of the series of byte of data to calculate, add the bytes together and drop the carries and take the 2's complement of the total sum and add, that is the checksum byte, which becomes the last byte of the stored information. To perform the checksum operation, add all the bytes including the checksum byte. The result must be 0. If it is not 0, then that indicates one or more bytes have been corrupted or changed during the storage or transmission. So we will see this one with the example. In the example, you can see 4 bytes are there. Find this checksum byte, perform the checksum operation to ensure the data integrity. If the second byte 62 had been changed to 22, show the checksum, how checksum detects the error. So first part of the problem, checksum is calculated by adding all bytes here. So when you add all bytes, you ignore the carry, you will get 18. So 18 to checksum byte is the you take the 2's complement of this checksum byte, which is nothing but E8. Then add all these with the checksum byte. When you add all these with checksum byte, you should get 0, dropping the carry. That indicates other bytes have not been changed during the operation. For example, here in this case, here you see, this is the checksum byte E8 in 2's complement. When you add E8 to the rest of the bytes, you should get 0. Suppose the 62 got changed during the storage, it became 22. That time, you will not get 00 when you add checksum to the other bytes. You will get some other value. This indicates there is an error. That means some of the bytes have been changed during the transmission or during the storage. This is called as a checksum. So very, very important. So here one example you see. Assuming that last byte of the following data is checksum byte, show whether the data has been corrupted or not. Now, in this case, these are the datas and this is the checksum. So now you add the checksum to the data. You will get here 00. You ignore the carry. That means the data is not corrupted. The data is not corrupted. So there is one more program that is called as checksum program for BIOS. So please go through it. I will give you it as assignment. Please go through it. So if any doubt, you can ask me. So I will reply for that one. Then next method is use of parity bit in DRAM for error detection. So here, how you can use parity bit in DRAM for error detection? This requires bit theory. So because the diagram given in your book is very much complicated, so you can read theory, little bit theory related to this one. So parity bit generation and checker in IBM PC. There are two types of errors can occur in DRAM chips. One is hard error. Some bits or electronic row of memory cells inside this memory chip get stuck or high or low permanently. That is called as hard error. Soft error is the single bit changes from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1 during the storage because of some surge current or because some other errors. That is called as soft errors.